Late last week, Judge Tanya Chutkan decided that she was not going to entertain Donald Trump's request from his legal team to pretty much bar mentions of the Capitol riot during his January 6th trial. Now, Trump's lawyers had argued before the judge in a motion that they filed a little while ago that in the indictment, there's a couple lines that, well, basically, they cite this one specifically. Large and angry crowd, including many individuals whom Trump had deceived into believing the vice president could and might change the election results, violently attacked the Capitol and halted the proceeding. They wanted that line stricken from court. And other mentions, of course, of the Capitol riot itself. Like, hey, don't bring up this really horrible thing that everybody already knows happened and everybody knows why it happened. Well, Judge Chutkan finally issued her ruling late Friday, and she said, no, I'm not going to strike that. And there's two specific reasons why I'm not going to strike what you call inflammatory language. The first one, Judge Chutkan said as she bashed Donald Trump, was your client is pretty much known for making inflammatory statements. So it's, you know, kind of a, I don't want to say tit for tat, but it is like, hey, your guy does it all the time. He does it about me. He's doing it about the court. He's doing it about the trials. So why can't we make inflammatory comments here in court? You don't get to strike that. The second reason, and this is, of course, the big reason why she said she's not going to strike it, is because you've cited no evidence to show that this will, in fact, result in jurors coming in with preconceived notions about your client. If you don't have evidence, I can't rule in your favor. This is a court of law. Everything we do is based on evidence. Every decision I make has to be based on the evidence. And when you come to me with none of it, what do you expect me to do? So Chutkan, of course, made the right decision here, and it is worth mentioning. I mean, the whole reason we had a Capitol riot was because for, you know, a month and a half, Donald Trump and his little allies were feeding these people lies. The same lies that caused Donald Trump to engage, allegedly, in the fraud to, you know, subvert the government, to block actions of Congress, all of that. It is all related. You cannot separate all of these events because they all happened in unison and they all happened because of each other. So again, Chutkan made the right decision here as she has done repeatedly throughout all of these pretrial motions. I'm glad that she finally got this one, you know, kind of done with. It's been floating around out there, by the way, for well over a month, but it's the right decision. And hopefully Trump understands that once he goes to court, you can't just say whatever the hell you want and get away with it. There are, in fact, consequences for your words. Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week. So if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.